Hey guys, Chris from Harmony Turbines here, coming at you with another installment of our SAF Simplified Axial Flux Generator series. And I want to explain a little bit to you today on the performance chart that we released with our live stream. That performance chart shows the difference between the very first simplified axial flux generator we made and the second one. They're identical as far as the number of turns, the number of windings, the distances, the air gap, the magnets, the sizes of the magnets, everything is identical. All we did between generator one and generator two was removed some extra material, removed some aluminum from the system, and basically we were looking at it from an eddy current standpoint. Now you're like, what the heck does that mean? Well, here's what eddy currents are. When you have aluminum and a magnet, I'm sorry, I held up the wrong thing. When you have a magnet and aluminum or copper, any type of non-ferrous metal, the magnet will not stick to it. It'll just fall away. But you see how it's kind of picking it up there. See how it's sort of picking it up? That's because when this gets near aluminum or copper, when this magnet gets near, it's like it's in molasses. Look at that. Look how slowly it falls there. It's because the eddy currents that it's inducing are creating resistance to the magnet's movement. And so that dragging is what's happening in the generator. So as we're running the generator with the turbine or spinning it with our hand, if we have a lot of these eddy current breaks going on, then you can imagine a large majority of the difficulty in spinning it and the torque required to turn this is increased by eddy currents. So between generator one and generator two, we shelled out and removed a little bit of extra material from the proximity of the magnets. We tried to increase the distance and get the aluminum out further so that the air gap was larger between the magnets and the sidewalls in our generator so that it wasn't as much of an eddy current effect. We're doing that even further. In fact, Jeremy right now, if you wanna, you can zoom in a little bit. He's actually working on that right now, shelling out and working on removing extra material that's not necessary. Now that's gonna do two things for us. One, it's gonna take the generators down from 58 pounds, I believe. Was that 58, Jeremy?
68.
68 pounds when we took our initial generator and weighed it. Down to, it could be as low as 50 pounds or even less. I think he was saying we might remove 25 pounds of material from this because we're able to shell out our extra aluminum. We're also able to get rid of some of the steel in our platters, our magnetic platters. So we're not only making the generator nicer and lighter, easier to handle, but we are getting rid of eddy currents while we're doing that. And that difference between chart one and chart two, the two lines there, it's almost double the performance if you look at that between generator one and generator two. Everything was identical between them except for the amount of aluminum we removed in generator two. So when he's done his work on designing, we're gonna go ahead and machine up another generator and we'll see how that one performs because it should be even better. Now this is some of the really, really exciting stuff that we get into because we control all of this, 100%. We don't have to go to an outside company. We don't have to wait 3 months for them to get back to us with pieces and parts that we have sent off to them to be redesigned or rebuilt. We can design and then machine those parts literally within a day or two. So you guys are going to be able to see the results of that effort. And when we have the next one machined, when Jeremy's finally ready and machines it out, we'll put the results of that one up against version one and version two. So this is really exciting stuff here because we're increasing efficiency in our generator in leaps and bounds just by making it lighter, making it a little bit more open space inside so we don't have the eddy currents to worry about, and just basically redesigning it with efficiency in mind. You know, we don't want to have something heavy and clunky and inefficient if all we have to do is make a few changes and we can have vast improvements in that system. So that's what we're here doing every single day, guys. We're looking at the problem from the ground up and saying, why is this happening? Can we make it better? And then the answer to that is we take it over the machines and we make it better. So Anyway, we wanted to share that little bit of information with you with a really nice demonstration on, you know, what eddy currents are. That's a beautiful example of it, how slowly that drags and falls. So that's what's going on inside of the generator every single millisecond that it's spinning. And you want to minimize those eddy currents as much as possible. So that's what we're doing, guys. Sharing that information with you, explaining that chart a little bit better. And, you know, that way you can look at it and be like, oh, wow, that makes total sense now. I see how much that changed the performance of that generator. So it was already really impressive in its first iteration. The second iteration was doubly impressive. It blew our socks off. We thought the first one was good, but then when we saw the second one, we were like, holy crap. We're getting nearly double the performance out of it just by removing some of the extra eddy current interactions. And that's really cool when you think about it. Okay, guys, so that's pretty much a wrap on what's going on there with the generator, with the charts. And at this point, we just want to say thank you for following along with us, for being here as our followers, as our investors, our community of supporters. We're here because of you. The work that we're doing here is to make a better product in the end for you. And something that you can be happy to have, something you can be proud to have, something that's going to perform excellent for you. That's our goal as Harmony Turbines. So if you like what we're doing, you like what we're all about here, guys, I would ask you to please consider investing. We could certainly use the investment. It helps us move forward. We are not funded by government grants or government incentives of any kind. We are 100% crowdfunded, and that means you can be part owner in Harmony Turbines. So if you like what we're doing, if you like what we stand for, please consider investing in our company and, you know, becoming part owner and helping us out with what we're doing here. We're doing everything we can to make a product that you in the end are going to love. So thank you, Chris from Harmony Turbines, saying take care. Until next time. Bye-bye. Harmony Turbines. We now have the power to change the world.